Schenken, thank you very much for your remarks. I'd like to now call on Marie Ruel, Director of the Poverty, Health and Nutrition Division at IFPRI, to provide an overview of the research program.
So this is our new research program, and just the point that Schenken made, that urbanization is really a big issue. Urbanization has been a big issue in the last 40 years and will continue to be until 2050. We will add 2.8 billion people in Africa and Asia by 2050, and this is 90% of the growth that will happen between now and then. There are multiple forms of malnutrition. I think we've all heard about that quite a bit by now. But the multiplicity of forms of malnutrition is currently worse in urban compared to rural areas. And this slide is showing data from 16 countries in West Africa. And you can see on the left side, this is showing how the prevalence of different forms of malnutrition changes with increases in income. And you can see on the left side that for underweight, as income increases, the prevalence of underweight in adults goes down, and it's very similar between urban and rural areas. What you see on the right side, the last two sets of columns, is the overweight data, and you can see how fast in urban area the prevalence of obesity goes up with increasing income. And people, when they move to the city, usually have their incomes increase. Even the poor, they have more cash than they do usually when they used to live in rural areas. So why is this happening, and why is it so bad in urban areas and currently worse than in rural areas? Because of diets. The main driver, the shared drivers of underweight and overweight, as well as micronutrient deficiencies, is poor quality diets. So they are driving all forms of malnutrition, including micronutrient deficiencies and overweight and obesity, and related non-communicable diseases such as diabetes and cardiovascular and diseases and some forms of cancer. So Schenken also mentioned the nutrition transition. That's also a concept that is absolutely not new. We've been talking about that for a very long time. But it's becoming very, very bad. And this is an example of what things look like in urban areas and increasingly in rural areas, where people have completely moved away from their traditional diets and consume diets that are really too rich in calories, in saturated fat, in sugar, and too low in fruit and vegetables and a variety of other things. Death by diet. This is an article that just came out from a journalist who was reporting on the global burden of disease, new data information on how poor diets are now the world's biggest killer. So here we're talking about premature mortality, death, disability, and disease. And poor diets are now the main driver of these problems. So the global burden of disease have looked at this information, and they're modeling 15 dietary factors. So those are the too much saturated fat, too much sugar, not enough fruit and vegetables, etc. So there's 15 dietary factors, which explain one in five deaths. So that's 20% of all premature deaths, and 11 million of people dying from these factors from having consumed poor quality diets. So the diseases that they're looking at are cardiovascular diseases, diabetes, and some forms of cancer. What you see here on the right side, which is surprising, is that the countries in red, orange, and yellow are the countries where this is really a very extreme problem. It's not the U.S. or America or Europe. It's Africa, East Asia, and Asia in general, that have excess mortality from these chronic diseases that are related to diet. I can explain in the discussion session why this is like that. I don't have time now. So what do we do about these issues, the diet issues, the disease issues, and the malnutrition issues? What do we do about this, or what do we do also about urbanization? So about urbanization, there is a lot more that seems to be going on than really trying to address diet. So there are many city initiatives. I'm just putting a few that could fit in the slide. The first one is the Milan Urban Food Policy Pact, which now has 186 cities signed up and actively partnering and interacting. And you have these other initiatives like C40 cities and 100 resilient cities. And those all focus on cities as a whole, on the city's resilience, the city's infrastructure, preparedness for climate change, adaptation, sustainability of the cities. And they also deal with issues of governance. And you can see on the right side, food security, urban agriculture. These kinds of topics come up in these networks and partnerships. But what doesn't come up very much is diet and nutrition and health and is the poor. So we thought it would be very good for IFPRI to complement the ongoing efforts that are more focused on global urban issues and for us to focus on the urban poor and their diets, their nutrition, and health. So this is what our urban program is about, the human face of urbanization and related problems. So just to introduce very briefly, Jeff and others will come back to what we're planning to do in more detail. Our conceptual framework is on the right side, and Jeff will explain it, Jeff Leroy. And so we have five research components in this program, and we will present only three today because we don't have time for more. So the first one is urban food environments, how the poor interact with their food environment and how we hypothesize that this may have impacts on their diets, nutrition, and health. Jeff is a senior research fellow in PHN, my division, the Poverty, Health, and Nutrition Division. The second speaker is James Tharlow, who's also a senior research fellow, but in the DSG division, which is Development Strategy and Governance. He will talk about urban-rural linkages. And the third speaker is Danielle Resnick, who's also a senior research fellow in the DSG division, who will talk about the governance of the informal food sector. Then we have the other two topics, supermarkets. We, as I said, we don't have a presentation on that today, but we will look at what is the contribution of supermarkets to the disaster we have, in a way, or how do supermarkets affect food choices, and is it part of the problem? And then we have another area, which is urban agriculture. So I'll leave it at that and invite Jeff.